Myself, D. Kirtanath, Assistant Professor, EC Department, St. Martin's Engineering College. Today I am going to explain a topic called as communication. Communication system. As we know, as we are well known, what is communication? Communication is nothing but sending information from sender to receiver. That means the sender to receiver. So, sending, what we are sending? Sending any information or data or any message. So, we are sending some of the information, data or message from the sender side to the receiver end. So what happens in this communication? So just we are sending information, receiving. But in between, what is going to happen? So what is happening? So what is the actual process of this communication system? Just we see. So sender, receiver. So in between the sender and receiver, what is going to happen? So after the sender is sending the information or the message to the transmitter. So, transmitter, from the transmitter, it is going to channel, and from channel, communication system. See, from sender, whatever the data, information or the message we are giving, directly it is coming to transmitter, and from transmitter to channel. Channel is nothing but a medium which is acting in between the sender and the receiver section. So a medium, the something information to pass through one form to another person, there should be some medium in between. So here the channel acts as a medium between the sender and the receiver. So what is going to happen? So the transmitter will be sending data to channel. From channel, the receiver section will be taking the information from the channel. Then at the destination. Destination is nothing but at the end of the, this is the end of the communication done. So whatever information coming from here, that is transmitted till here. So this is the system of the communication block diagram. So coming to this transmitter, at the transmitter section, there will be a modulator. So, at the transmitter section, there will be a modulator. What is the use of this modulator? What actually the modulator will do? So, the modulator will be varying the message signal. So, whatever the message signal we are giving, that signal will be varying according to the content. So whatever we want, that will be varying. So at the at the receiver section, there is a demodulator. Demodulator. So what is a demodulator? Demodulator is nothing but it is changing the whatever signal we are getting from this channel, it is changing into actual information, then it is transferred into the destination. So this is nothing but demodulator. So at the transmitter section we will be having modulator, at the receiver section we will be having demodulator. So this is a block, actual system of the communication network. So just we will go into depth what is modulator and what does it do and what are the modulation techniques involved in the communication system. Changing with the message signal. So this is nothing but modulation. So modulation takes place in two forms. One is amplitude modulation. bandwidth modulation, again it is divided into two types, which is frequency modulation and phase modulation. So these are basic modulations techniques which are involved in the communication system. So coming to this amplitude modulation, and again in this also they are subdivided into a number of sections. Just we will discuss in brief. So amplitude modulation and angle modulation. Coming to angle modulation, again it is divided like frequency modulation and phase modulation. So amplitude modulation. What is amplitude? Amplitude is nothing but a signal. Just we are taking signal, the peak level is called as amplitude. So just we are varying this amplitude of the message signal with respect to the carrier. That means just we are varying, changing this signal. So coming to this angle, in the that is divided as frequency and phase. So in the frequency, just we are changing frequency. What do you mean by this frequency? Frequency is nothing but if I take a signal, how I can tell that the signal has a frequency based on the time period? As we are thinking, f is equals to 1 by t, or t is equals to 1 by f. Based on this, we are changing the frequency of the signal. If I am changing time period, obviously the frequency will be also changing for the whatever signal we are taking. So the frequency will be changing of the message signal with respect to the carrier. Coming to the phase is nothing but if I take any signal, phase is nothing but the upper phase or 180 degrees phase, or else what is the phase of the signal. So changing the phase of the message signal with respect to the carrier is nothing but phase modulation. So these are the types of modulation techniques which are involved in the this modulation thing. Just we'll see what is amplitude modulation, how the signal varies in the amplitude modulation. So amplitude modulation is nothing but changing, as we have discussed, changing modulating means nothing but just we are changing. That means we are inserting both of the message signal and the carrier signal. See how the signal looks like after this modulation, after the amplitude modulation. We can just see the change, how the signal will be. Just we can observe the change. See, amplitude is nothing but the peak level of the signal. This we are telling it as amplitude. So this is negative amplitude, this is positive. So coming to this AM signal, this is AM signal. So this is the amplitude of the signal, whatever we are getting as a output. See here, the amplitude is reducing, yes or no? At a certain level, this is reducing. This is nothing but amplitude modulation, changing or varying of the amplitude signal is called as this amplitude modulation. No? Here the actual change we can recognize in the amplitude modulation. We can see here as well as here. That means the modulation is changing. That means that is reducing. We can either reduce or we can even increase the amplitude also. So here we can see a keen decrease in the amplitude of the signal. So this is nothing but amplitude modulation. Just we check for frequency. What is going to happen in frequency modulation? Frequency modulation here is nothing but we have discussed, right? Frequency modulation is nothing but changing or varying frequency. Changing or varying frequency of a message signal with respect to the carrier. So next we will be having phase. So here changing of the signal. That means here the gap is more because the frequency is increasing. As we can tell, there is a change in the frequency here also. There is a change in the frequency of the signal. These are like fixed together. That means a gap is less. While coming to this section, what is going to happen here? The frequency is increasing. Like the gap between the one waveform to another waveform is like increasing. So this is the change which will be observed in the frequency modulation. That is, frequency is changing. Yes or no? In this waveform as well as here, the frequency is, we can keenly observe that frequency is changing in this signal. So this is nothing but changing the frequency of the signal model we want with respect to the message as well as carrier. So this is nothing but frequency modulation. Just we'll check what will be the for phase modulation. Phase modulation is nothing but we have discussed changing of phase of the message signal with respect to the carrier. So how the phase will be changing? Observed in the phase modulation. That means the phase changing in the phase of the signal. We can observe in this way. The upper positive edge, the change in the frequency, the change in the phase, we can observe in this way. So this is nothing but phase modulation. So these are the three modulation techniques which are involved in the this modulation thing. So just we have discussed what is amplitude, what is frequency, and what is phase. So frequency modulation. Just we'll go in depth of AM. So what is AM? AM is nothing but amplitude modulation. Again, this we are dividing into many types. Coming to this first, this is conventional AM. Conventional AM here is nothing but full AM. Fully we are modulating the amplitude of the signal. That is full AM. Full AM is nothing but full amplitude modulation. So next coming to BSB, SE. Next is SSB, SC. Next is BSB. So these are the four types of amplitude modulation which is present. So this is conventional is nothing but the full AM. That is nothing but full amplitude modulation. So we are fully modulating the amplitude of the signal. Well, coming to this DSBSC, DSBSC is nothing but double sideband, suppressed calendar. So the name itself can depend that double sideband suppressed carrier. Suppressed carrier. The word suppressed is nothing but just we are suppressing the carrier. That means we are taking on the SS signal as well as carrier signal, right? So just we are suppressing the carrier. Suppressing the that means double sideband suppressed carrier. Coming to SSBSC, single sideband suppressed carrier. So here we are suppressing the carrier with respect to single sideband. That means only single sideband is suppressed. Coming to BSB, that is vesicle sideband. That means here we are just a sideband is being formed. So these are the four types of the amplitude modulation techniques. That means first is conventional AM, which is also called as full AM. Then DSBSC, this is SSBSC first. That means single sideband suppressed carrier. Then coming to DSBSC, double sideband suppressed carrier. And this is BSBSC. So these are the four types of things which are available.
Say thank you.
Available.